Welcome to the Before and After series, where I'm reworking designs prepared by novice UX and UI designers, with intention of improving them. Today I have prepared for you an example of mobile app design screens that offer online courses. Let's start from the first screen. As you can see, before and after screens have different dimensions. Most likely the author of the project intended it for iPhone 8, which as of today is a 6-year-old device. I think I already had a similar case in part 4 of the series. It's not necessarily a mistake, but when you are working on projects for your portfolio, you don't want it to appear outdated, unless there is a specific reason behind it. That's why I decided to change the dimensions to modern iOS and devices. Now, the next big thing you can notice is utilization of serif type font in the UI elements of the original project. Serif fonts are easier to read in printed materials such as books, newspapers, and magazines, because serifs guide the reader's eye along the line of text. However, on digital screens, serifs are harder to read. That's why you should almost never use them in UI design. I left the original font for the branding, where this type of font works best. Then I took the original color palette and generated a new one with a mix-up of some gradients. Reason behind this decision is that the app is intended for online courses, and yet the colors used are very much reminiscent of the medical industry to me. You can let me know in the comments if you agree with me or not. Let's move to the next screen. Here, the most obvious thing are sizes and colors of icons that negatively affect accessibility. They are barely visible due to poor color contrast, and they would be hard to select on real devices. That's why on my redesign, I made them bigger and optimized them so they are easier to tap by the users. From smaller things, the alignment of the user profile picture is off. Also, search and menu icons have some weird misalignments in them. So, after fixing that, let's go to the third screen. Here you can see a slightly different approach on my design. My intention here would be that through swipe gesture or tap on the menu icon, the primary navigation would slide into the screen. As on the previous screens, I replaced the serif font with sans serif one, but also you can see how big of a difference a good color palette can make. On the side note, I want to mention that on the original screen, there is no way for a user to go back, so anytime a user would open the navigation, the only way to close it would be to select something. So it's a poor experience. On the next screen there is a lot going on. You really need to spend a couple of seconds to figure out what is happening. That's why in good interface design, information architecture and layout planning is that important. I fixed readability issues through distance and proper labeling. Now all key informations are easily digestible. Similarly to the second screen, here we also have issues with visibility of control icons due to poor contrast and sizes. And since we are in the context of simulated interaction, we also need to give the user the ability to pause and resume the video. Last thing worth mentioning are the duplications of messages and changes to them. Here the user is in the context of the course that he or she just selected. Why then we need to remind them that they are watching course detail or saying how long it will take two times? It's time for the last screen. Most of the changes I already mentioned carry over to this one. We have issues with poor contrast, font, problems with alignments and inconsistencies in them. So as on previous screens, I fix them through a new font, better color palette, and fixes to sizes and alignment of UI components. If you like this type of content, you can watch other videos from the before and after series here. See you guys in the next video.